Today I'm going to be reading Fancy Nancy Oodles of Kittens by Jane O'Connor with the pictures by Robin Price Glacier. I was going to read with my cat, but he doesn't seem very interested in reading today. Fancy Nancy Oodles of Kittens. Ooh, what a dismal day. That means it's gray, 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 the plainest color on earth. So we're cheering ourselves up with a tea party. Mrs. Devine, Bree, and me. As Bree and I split the last pastry, suddenly we hear crying. It's coming from outside. Ew, ew. Lickety-split, we throw on our raincoats and go investigate. That's a fancy word for finding out what's up. Lo and behold, what do we discover in the doghouse? A cat! And that's not all. There are kittens, oodles of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bree and I clutch each other. I'm practically hyperventilating. That means I'm so excited I almost faint. Mrs. Devine helps us get the cat and kittens inside. Poor cat, she's a stray, she says. She's never had a home. Then Mrs. Devine explains that a brand new mother cat is called a queen. Ooh la la, how fancy. We find a carton and line it with soft towels. We decorate the carton and voila, a home fit for a queen. For many days, all we do is peek in on the little family. The kittens can't see or hear yet. They just sleep and drink milk. We call the queen Your Majesty, or Madge for short. She is very nurturing, which means she is an excellent mother. Little by little, the kittens grow and change. They are way cuter than cute. They are precious, darling, and absolutely adorable. These two are always together. They like to roughhouse and tumble over each other, but we don't like to play favorites, but I must confess, we love them the best. Mrs. Devine is going to keep Madge, but soon it's time to find a good home for all the kittens. One by one, the kittens leave for new homes. Au revoir, we say. Each time one leaves, that's French for goodbye. We are sad, but not brokenhearted, because Bree and I get to keep our favorites. We name them Sequin and Rhinestone. I shower Sequin with oodles of attention. I can't stop hugging and kissing her. No, Frenchie, I can't walk right now. I say, it's time for Sequin's dinner. I wish I could make Frenchie understand. Taking care of a kitten is a full-time job. Every day, Sequin and Rhinestone play together, and if our kittens ever feel homesick for their mother, we bring them next door. Can you think of a more ideal arrangement? Well, it would be ideal, except for one problem. Frenchie, she doesn't like Sequin. She growls and barks at her. What's wrong with Frenchie? I ask my parents. Maybe Frenchie is jealous, my dad says. She sees you giving Sequin so much attention. You don't remember, my mom says, but after JoJo was born, you were very jealous. Me? Jealous? I find that incredible. But maybe my parents are right about Frenchie. So I shower Frenchie with oodles of attention. I give her bubble baths. I dress her in new ensembles. I even let her lick peanut butter off of my face. Little by little, I let Frenchie come near Sequin. Sequin is only a baby. She's not mature like you, I tell Frenchie. Then I explain that mature is a fancy word for grown up. la. It seems to be working. Frenchie stops growling at Sequin. Soon, she doesn't mind Sequin playing with her toys. She even lets Sequin share her doggy bed. It's almost like Frenchie is Sequin's big sister. It's an ideal arrangement. Until... one evening, I can't find Sequin anywhere. We search high and low, inside and outside, but it's so dark it's hard to see. I'm growing more and more frantic, which is a fancy word for scared. What if we don't find Sequin? Then suddenly, Frenchie stands very still. Her ears pick up. Does she hear something we don't? Her nose twitches. Does she smell something we don't? Lickety-split, Frenchie takes off towards the clubhouse. We all follow, and lo and behold, there is Sequin. I nearly faint with relief. Merci, merci, I say to Frenchie. At bedtime, we cuddle in bed. I love you oodles and oodles, I tell Frenchie. I love you oodles and oodles too, I tell Sequin. And though they can't talk, I know they love me oodles and oodles right back.